Hi, this is Deb, and I'm going to walk you through one of our late night labs, just kind of a general approach to it. We've decided to use late night labs, and we like them a lot, so we hope you do too. But there are a few little things we need to tell you before you start. All right, there'll be two parts to this lab. You'll fill out a lab report that you submit through our website here on Blackboard, not through the Late Nite Lab website. You'll fill it out and submit it here, and I'll show you that in a second. And then when you're done, you take a quiz using your data over the lab you just completed. All right, so introduction. First thing you're going to do is download this file. This is what you'll download, and you need to enable editing. You'll see a little mark at the top. And so as you complete your lab, you fill this out. You answer these questions. That's what you want to do. So after you've completed the whole lab on Late Nite Labs website, on this document, then you save it on your computer. So save as, and you name it your name dot whichever lab it is. This was intro lab dot module one, so whichever module that lab's in. That way you'll always know which one you're doing, and it's pretty clear. So in review, you've downloaded this file, you filled it out, saved it on your computer, and you filled it out by going to the Late Nite Lab site, which I'll show you in a second. And then when it's all saved on your computer, just like I showed you, you're going to submit it. So you're going to browse your computer, attach the file that you named correctly, and make sure it's your completed file, and submit. Now let's look at a late night lab. You'll click on this link that you can get to right here. That will take you to a list of the labs we're using in this class. This is my teacher view, so I'm not sure what yours will look like, but you'll need to scroll down to the one that you're doing, and it opens up to a lab. And you'll see on the shelf, there are containers. And you click on here, you see the materials that you can use that go with this lab, and then the instruments. Just put your cursor over it and you can see what things are. Then importantly, over here is the lab manual. There's background information first. Be sure and really look at that. This one's just telling you how to use the lab, but be sure and look at these. They'll give you information that's important for the lab you're going to run. It's like your pre-lab. Then you can click on procedures, and you'll see the step-by-step things you're supposed to do. Lab notes, we're not really using those. Just put your answers on your handout that I give you, the lab report. And also, if you want to see something in print, you can actually use this key, this button right here, and print it off so you can see hard copy as you go through it. All right, so now let's go back to just how this works. All right, let's say I want to put, I need an Erlenmeyer flask. I'm going to put in 6 molar HCl. How much am I going to put in? Let's say I'm going to put in 15 milliliters. You need to enter that in. So now it's in there. You can put your cursor over it, and you'll see how much is there. Let's say I want to figure out what the temperature is. I'm going to go over here until I find the thermometer, which is right here. And so now I have 21.5 Celsius. And so let's see, what if I want to see how much it weighs as well, what the mass is? A mint. Then materials. I'm not going to use the same amounts. Oops, sorry. I'm not going to use the same amounts that you use because I want you to do it. Let's say I'm going to put in, pay close attention to decimals here. So let's say I put in 30. And you see I've got a reaction going. I have a temperature and a different mass happening. You'll be recording those in your notes. in your lab report. Another thing I can do, let's say I'm done with that one. I put it in the waste receptacle. Let me get another Erlenmeyer flask. Let me put in 15 mils of this. No, let's do 20 this time. I'm going to get my thermometer, get it in there. Then I'm going to do something else. If I double click on this guy, you can see that it's open now, but I can actually close it. Let's see what happens with a closed environment here. Let's go back to my materials. Let's say I'm going to put zinc in there again. It's going to automatically open up itself, blah, blah, blah. So let's put in 0.11 grams. And you have your reaction. So you record your temperature and your mass. So you completed your lab. You filled out your lab report. You submitted it through this link right here in our class, the completed copy, not the blank one. And now you're ready for the quiz over with your notes. So you click to launch that. You have 30 minutes. And then you work through your questions. And you'll answer these questions based on your lab. When you're all done, save and submit. I didn't do that, it'll warn you. And then you're done. You can click OK to see results. And apparently I didn't answer a darn thing. So, okay, that's how you do one of our labs, and all of them are set up that way. I'll do another quick intro probably when we start doing work with the microscope next module. All right, hope your first module has gone well.